citizens are going to see flooding in their homes, flooding on our roads, and that is going to impact productivity.
This episode of CU Live is sponsored by our friends at MORPC, the Mid-Ohio Regional Planning Commission, and features stories about local and regional partners that envision and embrace innovative directions in economic prosperity, transportation, sustainability, and an inclusive Central Ohio. MORPC's transformative programming, innovative services, and public policy initiatives are designed to promote and support the vitality and growth in the region. For more information, visit MORPC.org or click the link in the video description.
Hi, my name is Sejan Mormon, and I'm a reporter for Columbus Underground. I'm here with Dr. Edwina Teye. She's an associate planner for MORPC. Thank you for being here and talking with us.
Thank you.
So I want to talk to you about climate change. With MORPC's Sustaining Scioto Report, it details how climate change would affect water quality in Ohio. Can you talk about what Ohioans would see as a result of climate change?
Right. So we're going to see severe and increased precipitation in Central Ohio, and that will be translated into flooding, excessive flooding here in Central Ohio. That poses a lot of risks to our water infrastructure primarily. And then citizens are going to, if we don't keep our stormwater drains clear, for instance, citizens are going to see flooding in their homes, flooding on our roads, and that is going to impact productivity. Now, with flooding comes nutrient runoff. As water flows on surfaces, it picks up anything in its path. It could be dog poop, it could be grass clippings, it could be plastic, all kinds of things that we leave in our environment. All of these things are going to be carried during flooding, and it's going to dump itself into our water systems. That is going to be a threat to our drinking water. It's going to be a threat to our recreational opportunities. It's going to be a threat to our economic activities. And so these are some of the things that we are going to be seeing as a result of the impact of climate change.
So you talked to me earlier about how water conservation would play a role in the pandemic. Can you speak to that a little bit more?
Right. So we know one of the things that we need to do is to constantly wash our hands to ward off this virus. And so water plays a critical role in fighting this virus. But for recreational purposes, we know a lot of things were not available to us. But because we have water resources, because we are surrounded by these great water bodies, Central Ohioans were able to utilize it for paddling, for boating, for swimming. And all of these opportunities allowed us to let go of some steam as a result of the pandemic. So it's very important to make sure that our water systems are always clean, our water systems are always available, and they're always accessible to everybody.
What are you seeing in terms of water conservation and people becoming more aware about why this is necessary and why this is important?
So during this pandemic, we've not been able to do in-person activities. But in June, we rolled out our virtual River Fest, which would have been an in-person activity, where we rolled out messaging on conservation. And we saw a lot of followers on our social media handles, being where we introduced messaging that encouraged them to be conscious about their water usage and be able to protect the water that we have. And so we rolled out these messaging, and we've seen a lot of following on our social media handles. One thing we do is we have the Green Infrastructure Toolkit, where MORPC provides resources that can help our partners utilize when it comes to stormwater drainage, when it comes to installing green infrastructure to help mitigate the impact of climate change in their communities. Again, we roll out messaging, and we've seen a growing following of people on our social media handles. These avenues are where we roll out messaging related to conservation and some type of outreach programs that we do. So we're seeing a lot of interest as the days go by.
Thank you for talking with us about water conservation and quality. I really appreciate it. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.